In this video, we're going to cover TOGAF, or what is TOGAF, in 5 minutes or less. People often ask me, what is TOGAF? And TOGAF is an enterprise architecture framework, which really means it's a logical steps in order to create an architecture for your client. The goal with TOGAF is to make sure that we align the organization's people, we optimize the organization's business processes, and we align the technology at the same time so the business can be maximally efficient. Now, TOGAF does this and recommends 9 phases, and I'm going to go over those phases. The first phase when it comes to designing an architecture is what's called the preliminary phase. And the whole point here is to establish the groundwork for our enterprise architecture. And what we're going to do in this phase is define any kind of architectural principles we need or governance. And we're going to scope the architecture, what's going to be in scope or not. We'll identify key stakeholders and secure their buy-in for the architectural project. And that's really the preliminary phase. Now, once we get that done, now it's time for the vision. What are we trying to get to? Where's the business going? So that's the architecture vision, where we're going to set a high-level vision and business objectives for what we're trying to achieve with this new architecture. So we'll be scoping the architecture further. We'll be just combining the objectives of the project, the constraints of the project. We'll develop a high-level baseline and even a future target architecture. And here, just on the vision, we're going to try to get some stakeholder approval for the vision so we can move to subsequent steps. Now, once we know where we're going, now we need to figure out what the business looks like now and how we need the business to operate in the future. So we have to baseline the current business operations, how the business works, the current business architecture, and analyze the current business processes, capabilities, and limitations in the business, and then figure out what we can do better and create a new business architecture, which is new business processes and a new way for the business to operate. That's the next phase in TOGAF, the business architecture phase. Now, once we know where we're going, now we can start to look at the information systems architecture, where we're going to look at the data architecture, maybe our application architectures, and we're going to be really looking at some of the technology systems and see if the data and the applications are going to get us to the goal. Will it help our people work better? And if the answer is no, we're going to ultimately have to create a new data architecture. Now, an application architecture, but it's not just data that makes an organization run. There's going to be a lot of technology. So ultimately, we have to get to the technology architecture. We examine the organization's technology and then create a targeted to-be future architecture. Maybe it's data center, maybe it's cloud, maybe it's all of it. We're going to define the hardware, the networking, the IT platforming requirements, the technology stack. Now, after here, here's where we start looking for opportunities and solutions, where we look for our potential projects and solutions to achieve our target architecture. So, you know, now we might be saying, okay, here's the technology that's going to actually get us there. So we might be saying, okay, these are the virtual machines on our AWS, they're EC2 instances, for example. So here we're going to prioritize opportunities, evaluate solutions, develop a roadmap for initial implementation, and define the initial projects in a transition plan. The next phase of TOGAF is migration planning, which is basically planning all the steps to get to the new architecture that we've all worked so hard to develop. So we're developing detailed implementation plans and timelines. We'll address resource allocation, budgets, and risk here, create work packages, what have you. Now, the next phase is implementation governance. So we have to work and create a good governance structure for the architecture. Here, the governance will monitor the project's execution. They'll provide guidance and resolve issues along the way. The governance needs to be there to validate that deliverables and things are done on time. So after the governance is the last phase, which is change management. Let's face it, there are going to be things that are always going to change in a company. There'll be a new vulnerability, a new business opportunity, a new application, and the business is going to want to take advantage of that. So we need to create a change management process. Now, those are the 9 stages of TOGAF. Now, we've got a lot more videos on TOGAF on this channel that explain each phase in depth, that go deeper into TOGAF, but this was a TOGAF in 5 minutes or less video, or at least that's what I tried to achieve in this video. If you'd love to become an enterprise architect, then I'll tell you it's one of the best jobs in the world. Please join me on a completely free How to Become an Enterprise Architect webinar. The link is in the description of this video. If you've enjoyed this video, please give it a like, subscribe to our channel, and hit the bell to be notified of new videos to assist you in your architecture career. This is Mike Gibbs signing off for now, and I look forward to seeing you in another video. Take care.